Now let's go ahead with step number 2. Coming up, we're going to install the motor and also the motor mount to the transmission itself. I have a spare M2 Racing Performer brushless motor from Yokomo, and this is actually a 4.5 turn motor. See how we go. But before then, I've also prepared Yen Racing aluminum motor mount. These are actually quite beautifully made. So I think it's essential if you are thinking about using any brushless motor on the DF01s. Or else, you will probably come across these horrible scenarios where the plastic stock motor mount actually snapped, and once it snaps, we are talking about vibration within the motor mount, and then drop your spur gears and transmission gears. So aluminum motor mount, it's a must. So you guys can play. See here that the factory, the number of pinions have to match up with the matching numbered holes on the actual motor mount, and the Yen Racing alloy ones. Yes, the same hole layout. What I've done here, we're going to just use the stock pinion gear, which is 21 teeth. And these are actually the holes that we are mounting it to. We are actually utilizing the 4.5 turn brushes sensor motor. It will probably be a good idea to give these machine screws some very locker, or else the vibration might work the alloy motor mount loose, and we don't want that to happen. And I'm actually just going to use the washer as well. So the screws can grab onto the motor mount just a little bit better. Apply a little bit, not too much. As you can see here, that I've actually placed the washer in between the screw and the motor mount. I just want to increase the actual surface area for the screw, so give it that little bit more security. And as you can see here, now the motor mount, the motor is actually in place. I'm happy. Next up, step number 5 and number 6. We are going to complete the rear gearbox assembly. Here I have laid out some parts for the next steps. First and foremost, these metal bushings, well, I'm not going to use them. This is actually the original drive shaft that's actually used on the DF01 and TL01s, those kind of chassis. You can see here, it's just a piece of steel wire. It's hard. It's not part of the Top Force kit anyway. This is how they come in Top Force kit. This is the stainless steel. It's actually a hop-up option. It's actually included inside this kit, and it's very nice. And the propeller joint. Good. I'm just going to use it on my other Manta Ray project. Not for now. So that lift does with the air racing. It's lightweight aluminium drive shaft. And it also comes with the front and rear propeller shaft joint. It's a nice kit. Very light as well, so we'll go with this one.